So commission reports. Abby just did mine. Thank you. Vice Chairman report, local affairs, Billy.
Well, I get a lot of questions and comments about not starting on Memorial Day. Once I explain, well, people seem to understand, but historically it's been Memorial Day weekend, and so it's just going to take some adjustment, just like everything else, so they'll get used to it if we continue it. I know that Kim said she had 14 hours and 30 minutes now. Kim has been doing this for 5-6 years. She's been the community liaison for 6 years. She is known as the one to go to, so it's going to be, she may change jobs and title, but everybody still has her phone number, so. And she still has to go to the post office and the store, so she's not going to be totally out of touch what's going on. And I'll let Kim take it from there.
Good morning, everyone. Abby and I have started our visits with the local businesses. We started a little bit early this year. I don't usually start till May 1st, so we haven't hit them all. We have found several businesses are still closed, but hopefully within the next couple of weeks we can finish up this project. I present a calendar with all of the special events or non-daily departure events like the Friends Work Sessions, Fireman Engineer Schools, anything that's not a traditional day-to-day departure for the railroad, just to give the businesses the opportunity to either staff up or anticipate the need for extra food or keeping their offices open or their businesses open later at night. Amy has asked me to check around the community about selling Colorado and New Mexico flagged small impulse items, so shot glasses, mugs, magnets. And I had visited with the gift shops, and especially the gift shops that were a little upset when we opened the gift shop 5-6 years ago, and I haven't got any pushback from that. So one of the resolutions you'll see on the agenda today is adopting a new policy that allows for this and also incorporates it into our policies and procedures manual. We just finished a very intensive leadership training from Top Seed. It was 2 days, and I think we're still on that high, so that's been exciting. So in explanation, my contract expires today, but I will continue to keep that community relations module as chief of staff for CTO. And I want to thank Scott for his confidence and my ability to be a positive contribution to the team. So thank you. Now the exciting stuff. We've been contacted by by the New Mexico State Governor's Mansion Foundation. They do a Christmas ornament every year. This year it will be the Comer's and Toltec Scenic Railroad. Very excited about this. I have a little bag over there. It's full of them. I own every one of them that's ever been manufactured. So I'm really excited. When Scott and Abby were asking, what is this? I said, wait a minute, let me show you. I have a bag full of them. So our idea is it will be a 3D type ornament. This is a Route 66 ornament. So in 2014, the Route 66 Foundation was showcased. The other exciting thing about it is there's a narrative that will be included with the ornament about the route. So Abby will be moving forward with this project and writing the narrative and choosing the picture and doing all that. When you walk into the roundhouse, there's a whiteboard that it's a big whiteboard that says purchase your Governor's Mansion Foundation ornament. You can go up to the governor's office to purchase it. So this is going to be a really unique and exciting event for us. I'm really excited about this. And I'm happy to answer any questions any of you have.
Is it for this year?
Yes.
And to clarify, that's the Santa Fe Roundhouse.
I'm sorry, yes.
Or the governor has moved to Chama.
Yeah, it's And there are public areas in a governor's mansion that this foundation is responsible for upkeep. That doesn't come out of the general fund budget, so this foundation maintains the public areas in the mansion. So I'm really excited about this. What are you two giggling over there about?
To say you're excited is the understatement.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. All of us.
Yes. Yeah. When Scott got the phone call, I was beside myself for a couple of days. So anyway, I have a whole sack if anybody wants to look at them.
And these will sell out, so
yes.
If you're interested, you better buy them when they're available.
Yes.
So it's touch, don't take?
You can, no, yeah, you can only touch, you can't take.
John?
A couple of questions. First of all, thanks for the update, I really appreciate it. What do you know at this point about restaurant openings in Chama for the season, the new barbecue place? Is there a date that you know?
They were hoping to be open by the 1st of May, but once they got in the building, they discovered the roof had collapsed. So they're looking at May 31st. There is a new barbecue food truck that's located on the, don't mind me, the drive-in. Don't know what their hours are. I think it's just going to be a sporadic open when they can. Elkhorn is trying to get open back up. They are having staffing issues.
What about Boxcar?
Boxcar, I have been approached by someone that's trying to get it open back up. And Abby, didn't you say you saw advertising for staff?
Yes.
So. What about Chama Grill? I went by the other day and noticed it was closed.
No clue.
They're closed Tuesday and Wednesday.
Oh, they're closed Tuesday and Wednesday. Thank you, Mrs. Gibbs. So,
they were closed yesterday, it appeared, but...
Well, that's because the power was out.
Yeah, but I mean in the evening.
Well, they closed it.
Yeah, I think they just closed and stayed closed. A lot of businesses did that yesterday, except for Billy, who had a generator and fed us all.
A generous part.
Local, they're looking at mid-May. That's the last I heard. So.
And again, they're having staffing issues
yes.
also.
David?
With the Christmas ornament, is that you have to go in person to buy it, or is there an online?
You can actually buy it online.
Okay.
But it's really fun to go up to the governor's office and buy it. It's on the 4th floor. Push number 4. Anybody else? Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Kim, and thanks all you've done for us. We really appreciate it.
She's going to do it just under a different title.
Absolutely.
She's ours first.
I'll decide.
Scott, for... Capital projects.
Capital projects.